Hi everyone, it's Peter here again, the guy who hates tomatoes but loves front-end development. In today's shorter video, we're gonna look at the interview with Alex Pinzon, who is the author of Scroller.js, popular scrolling library. We'll look at the website deconstructions.com again. I'll give you a little sneak peek of some of the projects I'll be deconstructing. And then we'll deconstruct the Hobbit preloader for Mario from a YouTube channel question. Okay, so let's go into it. The first thing I wanted to mention today is the interview I just published. Interview with Alex Pinzon. Alex Pinzon, yes, because he's German. He's the author of Scroller, of the popular JavaScript library. And I gave him a couple of questions and published it on my blog just today. So you can go through it. There's a couple of good points. The biggest surprise to me, or actually not a surprise, but a bit of a disappointment, is that he actually likes tomatoes. Which, I'm looking for someone who hates tomatoes who can join my club, but Alex is not the one, but we're still friends. And there's plenty of other questions and some interesting opinions, some interesting points that Alex actually never used Scroller himself, and he actually doesn't build too many websites, which is surprising. And so you can jump on the blog and go through the whole interview. And if you ever use Scroller, then leave a comment with the URL to your project, or just say thank you to Alex for his work, because all the work he did on Scroller was in his free time. And if you feel like saying thank you for his work, then leave a comment under the article. The second thing I'm wanting to mention today is another update on the website deconstruction site, which is in the making. I'm doing a couple of deconstructions as we speak, and also launched the landing page where you can sign up so you don't miss the launch. It's 1 month away and 2 days. If you ask me why this date, I don't really know. I just need to set some date for myself, otherwise it would never go live. So yeah, I just picked the date. It's straight after I come from holidays, so it's a nice time for launching a new project. And I'll be releasing every week new article deconstructing the most popular sites on the web. So if you know a site, or if you know any effects you wanted to deconstruct, just submit it through the site. The URL is websitedeconstructions.com, surprisingly. And you can sign up or just come back in 1 month, 2 days, 10 hours and 59 minutes. Okay, to give you a little sneak peek of what would be included. So this is the images I'm getting ready for one of the deconstructions. This one is a Bulgari perfumes landing page, which I found quite interesting. And there is a nice background full screen video with some transparent PNGs on top of it and revealing different section in a very creative way. So I was curious how this was done, and I'm sure some of you as well. So this is an image deconstructing the whole structure of the page, and also a couple other sort of screenshots of what's happening. Okay, so that's websitedeconstructions.com, and the project's coming very, very soon. And the last thing for today will be a simple deconstruction of a preloader found on the Hobbit website, which Mario was asking how it was created. By the way, he's saying, "Your tutorial is very good. I learned a lot watching it." Thank you, Mario. I need more comments like this, otherwise I'll just close the shop and won't release any more tutorials, okay? So leave more comments, otherwise this is my last video. And now let's get to the Hobbit preloader. And he would like to know how it's achieved. There is an effect where the sword is actually fading in. I'm trying to reload the page, but it takes a while to actually load it. There is a sword sort of fading in, and also changing from black and white to colored or full color image. And yeah, it's quite interesting how it was put together. Before this loads, if it actually loads, I'll show you, this is the sprite which is actually creating that effect. So it sort of fades in and then also reveals the colored version. That's it in action. And if I bring the developer tools and scroll down, so I'll bring it up here. I don't want the sound. If we scroll down, there is a container called, what was it called? Loader shell. And it has another container with a div, with a background image, which is that sprite which I show you now. So that the image is in a background of a div, and what's happening during the preloading, the background is actually moving. So this number is actually moving from 0, 0, 0, and it's one by one revealing the frames of this sprite. Okay, so it's quite hard to show you in action because the height and width or the background position is changing very quickly. And I took a screenshot in a ScreenFlow and tried to play it back now a little bit slower so you know what's happening. And you'll see really that this number, the background position coordinates, it's changing, okay, while it's loading. So I'll try to play it back. I'm not sure how it's gonna go with while I'm talking, but I'll play it back and you'll see these two numbers going from zero to these numbers. Okay, so that's how it was done. Hopefully that answers your question, Mario. If it was me, I would probably try something simpler. I would probably overlay two images on top of each other. One would be the black and white, one would be the colored one, and then you can have two containers and change the width of the top one. So you would set z-index on the colored one a little bit higher, and that you would change then the width of that container as you scroll, okay, as you load the page. Okay, but yeah, obviously there is always multiple ways how you can achieve similar effects. So this is how The Hobbit was created. Thanks, Mario, for sending the question. If you've got any more examples you want to deconstruct, definitely get in touch. Thanks, Mario. And that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed it. I know it was a little bit shorter than usually, but still, I'm trying to bring you one video a week with a simple deconstruction and simple HTML, CSS, jQuery tip, plugin, or deconstruction or tool. And stay tuned for more. Definitely go Gunners, and don't forget to sign up. Bye.